Welcome to a new SiteGround video. My name is Cal Evans, and today we're going to learn about the MySQL database behind your WordPress website. We will talk about why you have one and what you as a non-technical site owner can do to speed things up. At its heart, a database is where you store things you want to be able to easily find. MySQL is one of the most popular database platforms available. These days, it's a lot faster than it used to be. Yes, it lacks a few of the bells and whistles of the commercial systems, but it's still free. Having a database is what has allowed systems like WordPress to branch out and extend their systems beyond just blogging. These days, WordPress is a great commerce platform, a headless platform that you can build a solid REST API on, a solid platform for podcasting. Oh, and yeah, it's still a great blogging platform. A lot of this flexibility is because it has a database behind it. The database allows us to store blog posts, podcast episodes, products, and orders all in one place. It also allows us to easily retrieve that information. The problem is that the database is still the second slowest place to store data on the web, the first being the actual file system itself. Yes, databases make finding the needle in that haystack of content easy, but if not properly tuned, you can run into problems quickly. So, if databases are so great, why are they so slow? A lot of work has gone into databases that run web applications since the early days of the web. Still, the more information you have in your database, the slower it will be to pull things out. Databases group data into tables. And to speed the retrieval of data from these tables, we create indexes. Think of an index as a card catalog for your blog post. We can quickly find the card in the catalog, and that will tell us where your blog post is. This way, we don't have to wander through the entire table looking for it. Indexes take memory, though. The bigger they get, the more memory they need to stay fast. When databases start slowing down, the one place we start looking at is memory. When a database runs out of memory, it starts writing things out to the file system, and now we're back to slow. Thankfully, this is a problem that we can throw hardware at. Up to a point, if your database is running slow, you can simply add more memory to the server running it, and then tell the database it can use that memory, and things will speed right back up. Sadly, for most non-technical site owners, this really isn't a strategy you can implement. You're most likely limited by your hosting plan. So, what can you do? You can select a hosting provider that has already optimized MySQL for you, or one that has Memcached set up and ready for you to use. To see if your current hosting partner has optimized MySQL for you already, ask them. They should be able to give you an unequivocal yes. If they can't, maybe it's time to bring in someone with more technical expertise to talk with them, or find another hosting partner. For example, SiteGround has optimized MySQL for their platform. This means that queries run faster, so web pages load faster. As for Memcached, you should also check to see if your hosting provider has it enabled. Let's see why you need it and how you can turn it on. Most top-level web hosts have implemented a different kind of database that we can use to speed things up. This is called a key value store database. Instead of multiple tables for each kind of data, you store a piece of data as the value, and it is given a unique key that is used to retrieve it. All of this is stored in RAM to make it very fast. Now, to keep from consuming all the RAM, we don't store everything in this type of database, mainly just the small and frequently accessed pieces of information. For instance, if WordPress uses my first name on every blog post, that would be a good piece of information to store in a key value store. This way, when WordPress needed my first name, it could quickly retrieve it without having to access the database. WordPress has a lot of small pieces of data that are needed multiple times per page load. Moving these to a key data store means that your system pulls them from RAM and thus loads them much faster. This all sounds complicated, and if your first thought is, I don't know how to set up a key value store, that's okay, because as I said, most top tier web posts set this up for you already. The most common key value store engine in use is Memcached. If you're using one of the best of breed hosts like SiteGround, all you need to do to get that speed boost that Memcached can provide is turn it on, install a plugin. It really is that easy. All the rest is handled in the background. No coding is necessary. Before you do anything though, test your current website's speed. My favorite way to do that is with webpagetest.org. A link to it is in the description below. Test your speed before you make any change to make sure that you don't make things worse. Then, after you've made the changes, test your speed again to evaluate the speed gains. So, let's see how easy it is to turn on Memcached on SiteGround. To enable Memcached on any site hosted on SiteGround.com, first go to Site Tools for that site. Click on Speed and then Caching. Come over to the Memcached tab. Here, you should see that Memcached is turned off. Click the slider to turn it on. A pop-up will notify you that this was successfully enabled. That takes care of the server side. Now let's tell WordPress to use it. To do that, we need a plugin. Go to your WordPress admin dashboard and click on Plugins and then Add New. In the search box, enter SiteGround Optimizer and press the Enter key. Now, find the SiteGround Optimizer plugin and click on Install. Once it's installed, click on the Activate button. Now we have a new menu item, SG Optimizer. Click it and then come down to Caching and click that. Yes, we should allow them to collect data to improve the reliability of the plugin. There are three types of caching. I recommend you turn them all on, one at a time. Today, however, we're only interested in the last one, Memcached. Go over and click the slider to enable Memcached in WordPress. A pop-up will let you know that you were successful. That's it. Now go back to webpagetest.org and retest. You should see an improvement in your speed. Turning on Memcached is the one thing that you, the non-technical site owner, can do to speed up your website's database if you're hosting with a top-tier web host like SiteGround. Databases have grown to become complex systems that require specialists to properly configure and tune. The best web hosts have people on their staff that do nothing but monitor and tune databases to give you the best performing website you can possibly have. If you're hosting your site on your own, it's up to you to understand the complexities of a database and tune it yourself. Let the professionals help keep your site fast. Now, I want to hear from you. Have you implemented a key value store like Memcached? Did it help your overall site speed? Hey, I want to thank you for joining us today as we learned. I hope you found it both educational and interesting. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click on the subscribe button on your screen to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the bell icon also so that YouTube will notify you every time we release a new video. Finally, follow us on social media to stay updated about all the news, trending content, and resources for successful website management that we share. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.